Many of you already know this, but some of you don't. Chad and I have separate bathrooms, and I am right now standing in his. And we've been in this house for 7 years, and in those 7 years, really not much has changed in this particular bathroom. So this week, we figured we would give Chad's bathroom a little bit of a makeover, not only to come up with better organization and storage solutions, but also, you know, to freshen the place up. So we're gonna go through how to make a small bathroom look amazing on a budget. Just so you know, we gave ourselves a budget of 150 Canadian dollars, and the goal was to find things that were equally as beautiful as they were functional. We've decided, because it's a pretty small space, that we're going to get rid of color and we're just going with clean white accents and the occasional black item thrown in there too. We'll start off with a garbage can. And this one is a nice narrow garbage can, because when you're in a small space, narrow things make a difference. Right now, Chad's got a pretty big round garbage can, and it actually takes up some valuable real estate. This one here is by Umbra, and it was $9. Next up is this decorative candle holder that Chad is actually going to be using to keep his toilet paper in. Usually he keeps it in a basket on top of his toilet tank, but that is valuable real estate that can be used for other things. So instead of having a big round garbage can, now he has that narrow slim one, and he can put this cool toilet paper holder right beside. And if you can't find this specific one, we picked it up here in Canada. You can find something similar at some sort of home decor store. No bathroom organization or decor video would be complete without a copious amount of baskets. So we have a black one here. This is a nice wicker one that Chad actually got as part of a gift. So he's upcycling this, way to go. And this one is going to go under the sink to corral some bottles and other products that shouldn't be on the counter. This one he picked up for $3. This little contraption here is an over-the-door storage container. And basically what you do is you open your cupboard door, obviously in the bathroom, you're so tight on space. It's a great way to expand how much storage room you've got. This portion over here then hangs inside your bathroom cupboard, and this little portion here hangs outside your bathroom cupboard, so it kind of hangs like this. This is great for towels, little hand towels or face cloths, and it's also great for a cleaning cloth. If you keep one in your bathroom just to touch up your counters and sink, you can rinse it out and then hang it to dry over here. Next up, we've got trays. And when you're buying trays, you gotta think about the space that the tray is going on to make sure it'll actually fit. When I interviewed Nate Berkus, he swore that trays were the perfect way to keep any surface looking clean and organized, but also keep your items corralled together and displayed pleasantly. So we picked up this tray for Chad. It's got two compartments here. One's rather large, it's great for toothbrush, toothpaste, that kind of stuff, and one smaller, perhaps for his contact lenses. And this one cost $8. As if waking up at 3 in the morning to pee wasn't enough of a rude awakening, the next worst part is when you have to flick the lights on and blind yourself, completely shock yourself out of sleep. So because that is not an enjoyable experience for anyone, the obvious quick solution for that is a little night light. Now these are LED lights that go on automatically. They're cool, they're cool, but they also stay cool because they're LED lights, and they plug right into the wall so you don't have to worry about replacing batteries. It's a great little way to illuminate a dark space in the middle of the night. This brush isn't really part of the makeover per se, but it is something that Chad needed for his bathroom. Now, it's not a large mascara wand or a super heavy-duty pipe cleaner. It's actually designed to go into your drain and fish out all of the hair that's clogging it up. And right now, Chad's sink is running really slow. So if that's happening to you, one of these will cost you $6. Just make sure you don't eat anything beforehand, because you might start to get nauseous while you're doing this, but all you need to do is dip this down the drain, give it the old swirl around, and then pull it out. There will be a lot of hair on there, but your drain will clear up a lot quicker. And if you want to clean your drain, all you need to do is dump a cup of baking soda down there, follow that up with a cup of boiling hot vinegar, run some water for a couple of minutes, and your drain will now be running beautifully and will also smell a lot better. Now, the $3 solution to never having to do that particular hair removal task ever again is to get one of these. It's a little hair stopper for your drain. Basically, you fashion this above your drain, let it sit there, and it catches the hair so that it won't go down the drain. And once your shower or tub has dried up, then you can just pick out the hair and toss it in the garbage. We have those small kid-size porcelain bathtubs in this house. So needless to say, the ledge that we have to work with to keep shampoo bottles and soap is very thin. That being said, it's really helpful for each of us to have a caddy in our respective showers. That way we can keep all of our items like body wash, soap, shampoo, that kind of stuff, elevated and easily accessible. Chad had this product from IKEA that used suction cups to stick onto the wall, and unfortunately, it never quite stuck onto the wall. In fact, there would be, you know, loud thuds at like 2 a.m. that would terrify me and the cats, and frankly, Chad. And really, it wasn't a robber, it was the stupid caddy in the shower just falling down because the suction wasn't working. So in lieu of that thing, he found this thing, which is an Umbra product. It was $13, and it basically hangs either off of your shower curtain rod or right off your shower head. It's plastic, it's got these cool metal beaded strings to keep everything steady, and it uses 2 sturdy hooks to make this thing hang wherever you need it to hang. For the longest time, Chad has had those slip-resistant stickers on the bottom of his tub, and over the years they've kind of worn off to the point where he basically has nothing, so every shower is a gamble. To protect him from having a situation in the shower, he decided to pick up a new slip-resistant bath mat, and this one has a very cool wavy pattern texture, which will probably feel fabulous on the feet. The benefit of having one of these is that you can rip it out, you can machine wash it when it's getting a little bit mildewy, but it's also mildew resistant, so that really shouldn't happen. And if you guys want a trick for not having those gross mildew buildups happening on your shower mats, all you need to do is lift it up after your shower and let everything drain so that it's drying independently of your tub and no mildew is drying out. Currently, when Chad steps out of the shower, he steps on these 2 tiny things. They're little rugs from IKEA. They're pretty much the size of a coaster, and they're super flat and unpadded. They're uncomfortable. They don't absorb water. In a word, they suck. And he really needed to up his bath mat game. So he picked up this double set here for $23. It is a mixture of cotton and bamboo, so it feels fabulous on the feet. You can machine wash these, which is great because these do tend to get really dirty. But the important thing is that they keep everything safe in the bathroom, because when you get out of the shower, they absorb water so you don't slip, and they also feel super comfortable underfoot. On the topic of feeling luxurious in a bathroom, nothing says luxury quite like nice, fluffy white towels. And that's exactly what he picked up. Each towel was $8, he got 2 of them, and this just makes you feel that much better when you get out of the shower and you can wrap yourself in a nice, thick, cozy, luxurious towel. Freshening up a bathroom with a brand new shower curtain is a great idea, not only because it looks better, but it is also legitimately fresher. Shower curtains get really nasty over time. Even if you launder them, they can just start to get gross. So we picked this one up. It's a really cool black and white design. It's got these kind of old-timey bath products on them. So it's really cool. It goes with the monochrome theme of the bathroom. And Chad picked it, so obviously he loves it, which is important. We paid $12 for this, and it's machine washable, which is great. You still use it with a regular shower liner, which we're just gonna keep from his old shower curtain, and that will be that. I've gotta say, this bathroom looks amazing. It's a small space, but with a little bit of a makeover, which, by the way, we clocked in at under $150, and a little bit of organization wizardry and cool solutions, we've managed to make Chad's bathroom feel larger and look cleaner. This week's comment question is, what space in your home needs a little bit of a makeover? Let us know in the comments down below. We're looking to do more videos like this in 2017, so your ideas will really help us out. You can also let Chad know what you think of his new bathroom. Just a quick reminder that all of the products that we mentioned in today's video will be linked for you in the description box down below. I've got two other videos for you to check out. Over here is a bathroom cleaning routine, super handy. And over here, 5 nasty things in your bathroom. Yes, it exists. You can also subscribe to the Clean My Space channel and visit our website, cleanmyspace.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.